15,000 years ago, ice covered most of the northern hemisphere. These days, we are heavily into a glacial recede, but does this mean that one day all of the ice will be gone? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, how will the Earth look when all of the ice melts? To some extent, ice ages and warmer periods are natural on planet Earth. The last ice age, the Pleistocene Glacian, began 1.5 million years ago and began melting in around 12,000 BCE. However, the world, to our knowledge, has never been in a situation where it has had no ice whatsoever. In fact, it is possible that our planet is currently among the warmest it has ever been. Scientists have predicted that, if we keep producing carbon emissions in the way that we do now, all of the world's ice can and will melt. It may just take 1,000 or so years. When it does happen, ocean levels will rise by 260 feet. So skipping ahead, if all of the ice in the world did melt and we had those few extra 100 feet of water worldwide, a lot of populated places would be underwater. Starting from east to west, here are some densely populated areas and cities that would be lost to the ocean. Large parts of New Zealand, including the city of Auckland. Asian cities of Singapore, Ho Chi Minh City, Bangkok, Shanghai, Dakar, Mumbai, Doha, Baghdad, and Bangladesh. Australia would have a brand new Great Lake through the middle of the country. Istanbul would be waterlogged, as would St. Petersburg and Helsinki. Say goodbye to large parts of northern Italy, including Venice, and goodbye to much of western France. Great European cities Brussels, Amsterdam, and London would be lost too, with the United Kingdom becoming much thinner, with the entire county of East Anglia lost to the waves. Scandinavian cities Stockholm and Copenhagen would be long gone too. North America would suffer hugely, especially the East Coast. While much land that had previously been frozen may now be habitable, many great cities and some whole states would be flooded. With the St. Lawrence River swelling, Montreal would flood, as would New York City, and Philadelphia would become a seaside location. Charleston would be long gone, as would pretty much the entire state of Florida. Goodbye Miami, goodbye Tampa, goodbye Disney World. New Orleans would be underwater too, as would Houston, Texas. Cuba would flood, Central America would suffer, including Mexico, who would lose Cancun. Hawaii would also face extinction. South America would see a lot of flooding to the east, with swathes of ocean infiltrating the northeast corner, washing straight through Brazil. Rio would be in jeopardy, but Buenos Aires would be totally gone. Forget the lost cities for a moment. Life is about to get pretty hot. Obviously, the Earth will have to have warmed for the ice to melt, but the ice actually helps to keep the Earth cool in another way. The white ice reflects sunlight back into space. Without this, more heat will be absorbed into the Earth, making climates even warmer too. On top of that, with all the fresh water melting into the salty oceans, the pH balance of the ocean may change slightly too, which can affect currents. If and when all of the ice melts, it won't just be catastrophic for humans. We would lose penguins, puffins, reindeer, polar bears, Arctic geese, Arctic foxes, walruses, Arctic wolf, seals, moose, narwhals, and more, not to mention ocean plant life, which helps purify the air that we breathe. For us humans, as the population rises and land masses decrease, we could be in for some real trouble. At the moment, it is estimated that 10% of the Earth's population is at immediate risk of displacement with the rise in sea levels. But if all of the ice melts, this could be much worse, as 40% of the Earth's population lives within 100 kilometers of the coast. Many millions, if not billions of people will need to relocate at huge economic expense, and overpopulation in some areas could lead to further issues like disease and poverty. Speaking of disease, we are not totally sure what is buried under all of that ice, but we do know that there are some trapped and dormant ancient diseases that we do not have immunities or cures to at the moment. If the ice melts and these are unleashed, it could mean a Pandora's box of disasters. So, life isn't looking so peachy without the ice. It is predicted that the ice will irreparably melt when the Earth's atmosphere reaches CO2 levels of 500 to 800 parts per million. The current level of CO2 is 409, with a rise of around 3 a year. This means it could take over 100, perhaps even 1,000 years for all of the ice to melt. So if we don't plan on changing our harmful human behavior, we'd better make a pretty serious contingency plan for life without swathes of landmass and species we currently have. So there you have it, that is one big question answered for you. What would you like the answers to next? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, do hit that bell button for notifications from our channel, and always show us some love by giving us a good thumbs up. Thank you for joining me here on Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, I will catch you in the next video, but for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. If you enjoyed this video, here are two more videos I think that you will like. Check out our video on what would happen if the Earth lost oxygen for 1 minute, and our video asking what would happen if the world was turned upside down. Blimey.